Hello students. Now in last lecture we are discussing the Ostwald dilution law. Okay. Now today we are discussing the numericals on the Ostwald dilution law. Okay. So in order to solve the numericals, the formula we are using are k is equal to alpha square into c, which is the same as alpha is equal to square root of k upon c, or alpha is equal to under root of kb divided by c. Similarly, the percentage of alpha is equal to alpha into 100. In the case of the strong acid and strong base, as they are completely dissociated, so H plus ion concentration, for example HCl, as HCl dissolves in water, it can be completely dissociated. So therefore, the concentration of the H plus ion when dissolving the water will be nothing but the C. So the concentration of H plus ion is nothing but the concentration of the solution, because it is completely dissociated as alpha is equal to 1. Similarly, in the case of the weak acids and weak bases, as weak acids and weak bases are not completely dissociated, so H plus ion is equal to alpha into C. So now let us consider the numerical on this formula. So first numerical, numerical number 1. A weak monobasic acid is 0.05% dissociated. A weak monobasic acid is 0.05% dissociated in 0.02 molar solution. Calculate dissociation constant of acid. Calculate dissociation constant of acid. So that is a numerical number 1. So weak monobasic acid is 0.05% dissociation. So it is given as a percentage dissociation, that is a 0.05. In 0.02 molar concentration, so concentration is given 0.02 molar solution. So calculate dissociation constant of the acid. So we have to find out K for the acid. Okay. So as percentage dissociation is given, so it is possible to find out the alpha from this. So we know that percentage of the alpha is equal to alpha into 100. So we require alpha. So alpha is equal to percentage of alpha divided by 100. So percentage of the alpha is 0.05 divided by 100. So 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by 10 raised to 2, that is 5 into 10 raised to minus 4 is the value of alpha. Okay. Now we require K. So by the Ostwald's dilution law, alpha is equal to under root of K upon C. So we want a K, so we can consider K is equal to alpha square into C. So alpha 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 into its square into C 0.02. So when you put up these values, we get answer. So square of 5 is 25 into 10 raised to minus 8 into 2 into 10 raised to minus 2. Okay, so it is a 25 as a 2, that is 50 into 10 raised to minus 10. Okay. So my answer is 5 into 10 raised to minus 9 is the answer of dissociation constant of monobasic acid. Okay. I again repeat, what is given? Percentage dissociation is given. Then concentration C is given. So from the percentage of the alpha, I can find out the alpha. So alpha is equal to percentage of alpha into 100. Then according to the law, put up the values in the formula. So we use this k is equal to alpha square into c, as we have to find out the k. So put up the value of the alpha. When you put up the value of the alpha, you get answer. That is the 5 into 10 raised to minus 9. Now the next problem. The dissociation constant of ammonium hydroxide is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. Dissociation constant is given. Dissociation constant of ammonium hydroxide is given. Calculate. Its degree of dissociation. Calculate its degree of dissociation in 0.01 molar solution. So again, what is given? Dissociation constant of ammonium hydroxide is given. Dissociation constant of ammonium hydroxide, which is the base, so Kb is given, 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. We have to find out, calculate the degree of dissociation, that is alpha. The concentration is given, 0.01 molar. Okay, so we know the formula. So alpha is equal to under root of Kb upon C. So what is the value of the Kb? Under root of 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5 divided by the C, 0.01. Okay, so let us solve. So 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5, this is the 10 raised to minus 2. Okay, so again 1.5 right here. So 1.5 into this 10 raised to minus 2 will become up, so it is 10 raised to minus 3. Okay, so in order to solve this, we require the term is given. So multiplied by 10 and divided by 10. So 1.8, okay. So 10 raised to 3 is converted to 10 raised to 4. So divided by 10, and now 1.8 is multiplied by. So 1.8 is a multiplied by 10. And 10 raised to minus 3 is a divided by 10. Okay. So my simple things, you convert it. So it is a 18. This is a 18. I will multiply by 10 and divide by 10. So the same terms we will consider into 10 raised to minus 4. So under root of 18 into 10 raised to minus 4 will become, so it gives 10 raised to minus 2. So the square root of 18 is a 4.242 into 10 raised to minus 2 is the answer for degree of dissociation. I again repeat. So what is given? Kb is given, C is given, we have to find out alpha. So alpha is equal to under root of Kb upon C. So Kb is 1.8 into 10 raised to minus 5. The concentration C is given, it is a 0.01. So just solve 10 raised to minus 2. So this 10 raised to minus 2 becomes a 10 raised to minus 3. And we require here even terms. So I multiply 1.8 by 10 and divide 10 raised to minus 3 by 10. So the 10 can cancel, and it is as it is. So 1.8 into 10 is 18, and this is 10 raised to minus 4. So square root of 18 divided by, so I get answer, under root of 18 is a 4.242 into 10 raised to minus 2. So this is the second numerical. Okay. Now next numerical number third. A weak monobasic acid is 12% dissociated. Is 12% dissociated in a solution. What is what is percentage dissociation, what is percentage dissociation in 0.15 molar solution, what is percentage dissociation in its 0.15 molar solution. So weak monomeric acid is 12% dissociation. So percentage dissociation is given, that is the 12%. Okay. So in its inner solution, whose concentration is given 0.05 molar. So concentration of the first, suppose this is alpha 1, its concentration given is 0.05 molar. What is the percentage dissociation in second concentration, that is a 0.15 molar, its concentration will be asked. So suppose it is a alpha 2. Okay. So a weak monomeric acid is a 12% dissociated in a 0.05 molar solution. So this concentration is given. We have to find out the percentage dissociation in the second concentration. Okay. So two concentrations are given. But as monobasic acid is the same. So for monobasic acid, K is the same. So therefore, I can use formula. K is equal to alpha 1 square into C1. K is equal to alpha 2 square into C. As the same monobasic acid we use, this K1, suppose it is K1 and K2. So K1 and K1 is equal to K2 because the same solution we are using. So therefore, equating these terms, I can get an equation alpha 1 square C1 is equal to alpha 2 square C2. Okay. So we have, to find out alpha 2. So consider the equation. So alpha 2 square is equal to alpha 1 square C1 into divided by C2. Okay. So now percentage dissociation is already given. So it is a 12%. Okay. So alpha 2 square is equal to, the value of alpha 2 is given is a 12. Okay. So percentage dissociation converted into alpha. So percentage dissociation is equal to alpha into 100. So value is equal to 12 divided by 100. So it is a 12 into 10 raised to minus 2. Okay. So now put up these values. So what I get? So this value is for alpha 1. So alpha 2 square is equal to 12 into 10 raised to minus 2 into C1 is given 0.05 divided by C2, that is 0.58. So alpha 2 square is equal to 12 into 10 raised to minus 2. 5 into 10 raised to minus 2 divided by 15 into 10 raised to minus 2. I can adjust the term. So this 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to minus 2 cancel. 5, 3 is 15. To the 4. So alpha 2 square is equal to 4 into 10 raised to minus 2. Alpha 2 square is equal to 4. So this is a square. This value is a square. So alpha 2 square is equal to 144 into 10 raised to minus 4 into 5 into 10 raised to minus 2. Here 15 into 10 raised to minus 2. So this 10 raised to minus 2, 10 raised to minus 2 cancel. Okay. So this is 48 into 10 raised to minus 4 is a alpha 2 square. So therefore, alpha 2 is equal to square root of 48 into 10 raised to minus 4. So square root of 48 into 10 raised to minus 2 is the alpha 2. Now, square root of 48 is the 6.93 into 10 raised to minus 2 is the alpha 2. Okay, now we want percentage dissociation. So, what is the formula for percentage dissociation? So, percentage dissociation is equal to alpha 2 into 100. So, percentage of alpha 2 is equal to alpha 2, 6.93 into 10 raised to minus 2 into 100. Okay, so percentage dissociation I will get as a 6.93. So, my answer is the 6.93 is the answer for percentage of alpha 2. Okay, so like this way. So, as the two concentration are given, one percentage of alpha is given, we can find out the percentage of the alpha 2 just by comparing the equation and just by putting the equation. So, just take care that this equation is for the alpha 1 square. So, the value I put here alpha 1 square and the C1 and C2. So, when I put these values, you can get answer like this way. Okay. So, like this way, in today's lecture, we are discussing the numericals on the Ostwald's dilution law. Okay. Thank you.